Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Chris, and I'm a product research engineer at NVIDIA. And today I'm going to talk to you about how we can leverage NIM operator in order to scale horizontal pods in a way such that it can effectively accelerate evaluator microservice. So you can imagine that you have some number of evaluation jobs you wish to do, and you want to ensure that you're getting these done as quickly as possible, up to and exceeding even closed-sourced API rate limits. The idea is pretty straightforward. The first thing we're going to have to do is just make sure that we install the actual NIM operator, which is not a complex task. Once we've done that, we do want to make sure we add Prometheus, since we're going to be using metrics to determine when to scale our replicas up and down. We're also going to set our pull secrets. This is so that we can actually pull the containers that we need. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to, you know, build a manifest for our NIM. So I've actually done this already, so let's take a peek at that now. So as you can see, this is our manifest. You'll notice that we're going to go ahead and we're going to use the Llama Nemotron Nano 4B model just to showcase how this acceleration works. And you'll notice at the bottom here, we have this scale enabled to true with min and max replicas equal to 1. Now, what this means is that regardless of how high our metric is, we're going to always only have one replica. So you'll see that we're going to judge this based on the number of requests waiting, and we're going to just set it to 5 to demonstrate the scaling. So what we're going to do now is we're going to take a peek at what this looks like in our pod, and then we're also going to look at how this looks in Evaluator microservice. So as you can see, we can run the command get pods, CR pods, and you can see that we have our nano pod running since we have minimum replicas set to 1, and then this is our operator running. You can see these have been running for a little while as I prepared this demo. We can also look at our horizontal pod autoscaler, right? This is going to show us that we have 1 of 5 targets, which means there's 1 request waiting. We have a min pod of 1, a max pod of 1, and current replicas is equal to 1. So this is the idea that, you know, we're only ever going to have 1 replica. So let's look at an evaluation job and see how long it takes with that single replica. For our actual evaluation job, we're just going to be doing some custom LLM as a judge, right? The idea is we want to scale this custom LLM as a judge as hard as we can using the available compute in our Kubernetes-enabled environment that we're running NIM operator on. Take a look here and see that this is actually the evaluator notebook. This is the standard evaluator notebook that we use for custom LMS judge. It's available on GitHub in our generative AI examples repository. And what you're going to notice that this is the standard flow, right? The only thing we're changing is actually the scaling that's available to our NIM. So we don't have to change anything about the way we're leveraging evaluator. In fact, we can use evaluator through whatever means we're most comfortable. In this case, we're using a Docker deployment for our testing. You'll see that we've set up our NDS, that's our data store, and our NeMo, that's our evaluator URL, as well as creating a namespace. The rest of the configuration is very standard. The thing that changes is that we're actually going to use our judge model config, which is tucked behind the API that we're currently port forwarding through our operator deployment. So this model is actually exposed through NIM operator, and this is what's going to give us that scaling eventually. Though for this instance, we only have 1 replica available with a maximum of 1 replica, so there is no scale to be done here. After setting up our evaluation config, which is just the typical LLM as a judge config, we can go ahead and create our job. We can see that the total job, you know, we pre-cooked this before the show started, right? The total job time is 24 minutes, 1 second, and some number of milliseconds. And we can see that we got decent results in line with what we would hope to see. Now we're going to come back to our config, and we're actually going to make a change. So for max replicas, instead of having max replicas equal to 1, we're actually going to change this to 8. And the reason we're going to change it to 8 is because we have available to us 8 GPUs. So that's the reason we're choosing 8 here. Now we have up to 8 available replicas, which means that we're going to be able to experience some of that scaling. As you can see, we still have this 1-1-1 set up here. What we have to do is, now that we've created or updated that YAML file, we have to apply that YAML file to our NIM operator instance. And what we can do then is see that we've now got a max pods of 8. So what this means is that we're actually going to be able to spin up to 8 replicas. And we've kicked off our evaluation job, and we can now see that we have a number of targets that's exceeding the actual, you know, requisite time that we wish to scale our replicas. As you can see in real time here, our replicas are actually being spun up, right, in order to suit the total volume of requests we're getting. So as we're talking, these replicas are being spun up to help us complete our, you know, job that much faster. And you can see, again, this is happening, you know, real time, and we get to see that scaling occur. Let's go back to our job and see what impact this had. And as you can see, it took about 2 minutes to spin up all these replicas. So there is some amount of overhead that is, imparted during this process. And now looking at a previous evaluation job that I had the auto-scaling set up for, we can see that, you know, we are able to submit the request. And we can see that it takes a total of 3 minutes and 44 seconds. Which is a scaling factor of about 7 times. Again, there is some overhead here due to the fact that we have to spin these replicas up, but the idea is pretty straightforwardly that, you know, the auto-scaling from NIM operator massively accelerates, nearly linear, especially as the data set size grows, it accelerates, evaluator microservice, and it's able to do this without the pesky kind of rate limits that you might see from, you know, third-party or closed-source providers. Thanks so much for watching this demo. My name is Chris, and we'll see you in the next one.